know from you what prompted you to ask for this special viewing.
At the onset, let me extend my grateful thanks to UN and India. Yuri, thank you so much for acceding to my request. Radhika Kaul Batra, I don't know where you are in the house, but you've been an extremely supportive person of this gesture, this initiative. So my grateful thanks to the UN and India team. There are two reasons why I requested Yuri and his team to ensure that this movie is screened for those people who are associated with UN in India. Firstly, it's very difficult. In fact, for the first time possibly in Indian cinema history, we have a male actor who's a celebrated superstar to tug his wagon to a very, very different concept. As somebody who's been an actor before, I have never seen actors being courageous enough to take on subjects which are otherwise not very financially successful, or at least not projected to be very financially successful ventures for them, and to come and become a part of a project where he in some way takes this issue and makes it a commercial success speaks a lot about a brave choice that the actor has made. And as a male actor to stand by such a project, I think I'm sure UN in India would also appreciate, from an entertainment perspective, it was very, very essential that this project succeeds, because its commercial success and the fact that it's valued societally is extremely important for taking the message forward. Secondly, the producer is a female producer, and they are very rare in the media business to have a female producer in the film business. And normally when you start out in a project, people tell you, why don't you do concepts which are financially viable or which are bound to be successful? She has a superstar for her husband, not that she's less of a star herself, but for her to pitch in her reputation, her monies, for such an extraordinary project, I'm here in support of that effort and for taking that courageous decision. Obviously, I must here add that to say that Balki is leading the project, for anybody from the creative fields, it is a given that it will be a good story told. And when I walked in, I had Yuri totally engrossed in Akshay's speech, which says a lot about the director and the way he's projected the entire story. That I'm a Radhika Apte fan is a given. In my ministry also, they say that if there's a Radhika Apte film, hide it from Shruti Irani, because she will find a way to watch it. But more or less, I think, apart from all the actors and the production and the directorial team, this story is about a man who did something very, very unconventional. He's standing right behind and beside the superstar. But when he decided to undertake this journey, he never knew that one day there'll be a movie about it. Nonetheless, he was courageous enough to take the step. Imagine his battles, which today look very easy on screen, but imagine fighting those challenges in a society which looked upon a man with wonderment. Ki ye kyun kar raha hai pad ke bare mein baat? So this is to pay homage to your life journey. And that you had the courage to undertake this journey without any guarantees that it will succeed. So here's taking from that dialogue that Akshay said, that many people have a lot of R&D and money for that, but I believe in TNF as well. And if it was not for men like you and people like you who tried extraordinary things in very, very difficult circumstances, the TNF formula wouldn't have given us such a beautiful story to tell. So I'm standing here in support of this gentleman.
Thank you, and thank you for the discerning eye, which said, yes, we must have more attention to this for the reasons exactly which you said. Thank you so much. Arunachalam ji, your name itself signifies strength and immovability, and your work has signified some of the values that India has traditionally stood for: courage in the face of opposition, the conviction of what you believe in, irrespective of who says what, to take your stand in that and to see it through to the very end. Also the value of short, which is held in such high esteem in India, and which is embodied in programs like Swachh Bharat. You have caught the essence of short for dignity and for cleanliness and for a wholesomeness in life. So please say a few words to us about what took you on this journey.
First of all, my sincere thanks to everyone. I saw your emotions while you were watching the movie. Literally, I started crying from the 10th minute. So, so I'm unable to stop. People are taking selfies with me. I'm crying. Okay. So, dear gentlemen, you have to note down an important point. Everything I started from my wife, now it is gone global. Please, if you want to do anything, please start from your wife. Okay. That is important. So, and the problem which I'm trying to solve is Himalayan problem. So still now 88% of Indian women are not using sanitary towels. Then even Indian condition is like this. You just think about sub-Saharan countries and the rest of the world. And don't think even developed nations are well. Many developed nations are having the problem. I have a team from even New York, German, even from Swiss. So the menstruation taboo is everywhere. So definitely this film not only for be made for India, this film be made for the world. Thank you, Balki. So please talk about menstruation freely, at least 2 women every day. Make India as a 100% sanitary producing country soon. Thank you very much.
So although Arunachalam is immovable, the Himalayas are movable. So I'm, because they're still moving. So I think we can overcome this problem. Mr. Balki, if you'd say a few words to us about why you chose to produce this.
To direct this?
Direct this.
The
Sorry.
Producers are there. exactly, you know, I made this film. We've been showing it to people. I was just watching one man. I wasn't watching the film. For me, the most important thing is I was always very nervous whether we'd be able to do justice to such an incredible life and such a journey. And also, I think, yes, of course, we know the problem is acute. There's been no film made in the world about this topic. But to just capture it with this kind of a story, with it's almost like a thriller. I keep telling him, you're a thriller, actually. You're not this thing. And he's a thriller to me. So I always look at him as, yeah, very good. You've done a lot of good and all this stuff. But let me see the story. Let me see the story. Tell me more gossip. Tell me more gossip. Let me this. So he is actually, to me, not only a visionary, a missionary of things, but he's possibly the greatest storyteller of his own life. He's made his own story and lived it, which is a fascinating thing. And that's why I wanted to make this movie. Thank you.
Thank you. And the producer. This is a very courageous and a very difficult topic to make a film on. So what was the reason that you did it?
People ask me that, why are you making a movie on menstruation now? You know, what is it? And I always feel that even if we want to pass on a message, you have to find a conduit, an entertaining conduit. And when I found Muruganatham's story, it was compelling. So I had a story which I could pass on a message entertainingly. And I'm hoping that Padman, more than a movie, is part of movement where women are no longer held back or embarrassed by their biology. I want to ask all of you, how many women have their period right now? Could you put your hands up, please? Well, this is something that even I would have shied away from, you know, maybe a year ago. So I'm just hoping that this is part of a conversation which has already begun, and it's something that cuts across, you know, culture and religion. And in fact, I think that it is something that I'm hoping is globally seen. Thank you.
Twinkle, you're absolutely right about that. And there was this one line in the movie where he says that ye rivaaz hai, to bahar chale jao, rivaaz badal jayega. It's just as simple as that. There's some things which are just limitations in our head. And speaking about them, airing them, being open about them, taking your photograph with a pad, wow, that just changes the rivaaz, doesn't it? How was it for you, Radhika, to be in this film?
I'm really overwhelmed right now because it's the first time I saw the film. And I didn't know who was sitting next to me, so I was trying to like hide my tears. And in the interval, I realized it was Balki, so the second half he gave in. But I am so, so happy to be a part of this project. He, the real Padman here, had the vision and the courage to do it. She had the vision that this should be made into a film and bloody reach everybody.
Bloody
Sorry.
Bloody reach everybody, please note.
And very, very importantly, I think such a delicate subject to be put in such a beautiful and innocent way that your heart literally like goes for it. Thank you, Valky, and thank you, Akshay, for actually putting it that way, because this is the only way it's going to reach, it's going to touch your hearts. And I think there are so many things said in the film, because it begins there, it begins from the father raising the daughter in the way he does. And when he tells him that it's exploring the feminine side of you from within. It just speaks about so many things. And Sonam, we are missing you here today.
Thank you so much. It's exactly like he did say in the film, that you really become a father when you also learn to be a mother. Nishtha, would you like to say a few words about what the UN does with regard to menstrual hygiene?
Sure. I think it's a very, very humbling moment for all of us in the UN that we picked up on such a revolution that was happening somewhere in the south of India, and we managed to capture and take the story with you to the rest of the world. We, of course, as the UN family, are committed to the issue. We work with governments, central and state, in ensuring that, in raising awareness, ensuring that affordability and access do not remain an issue for 80% of women who still continue to use cloth for menstrual management. UNICEF and UNFPA, of course, have integrated menstrual hygiene in their life skill education program that reaches out to 1 million adolescent girls and boys. UN Women, of course, works globally and in the country on ensuring with a variety of actors that the message is far spread, wide, and reaches to each of your hearts to ensure that menstruation is not a taboo, but is something that affects our everyday life, and we embrace it with all our heart and make it an issue, and in fact, ensure that it's no longer an issue and is treated with the normality that it deserves in our lives.
Thank you so much, Nishtha. Everybody's been waiting to hear from Akshay, the hero. And what we would like to know from you, Akshay, is...
Linglish, not English,
okay. Linglish, Hindi, English, English, anything. Do tell us what changed for you as a human being having depicted this role.
Well, he was saying just now... Okay, I'm trying that English bit. I don't know, he was saying a few minutes back that his life started from his wife, the journey. And so same here also, for me also, knowing about menstruation started, my wife told me about it. And I came to know more about it through my wife, because my father, mother never told me much about it. They also hid it from me. I didn't know anything much about it. I just knew that there is something called the girls have periods and 5 days unka period chalta hai. And but that much only knowledge I had. But lots and lots I came to know through her. And then she wanted to make this a very small film. But I pleaded her, I begged her, let me do this film. I want to do this film. I want to act in this film. And here we are. What happened? Did I say anything wrong? Trust me, I have to. Smitiji, I really have to.
Some men put on a pink ribbon here to wear a pink underwear. So,
so I did. I succeeded in explaining it to her, and here we are seeing this day, and I'm so. So happy, and thank you, Tina. Thank you very much for giving me this movie.
So we want to know what changed, Akshay.
What changed?
For you.
Lots of things changed in my head. Lots of things changed. The way I look at it now, the way I feel it, the way when I talk to people about it, and mere andar ka, matlab, bahut sari cheeze badal chuki hai mere andar. I mean, that I cannot even iska jo jazba hai, main bayan nahi kar sakta. अगर आपने वो स्पीच देखी द स्पीच विच यू सॉ इट इज एक्चुअली 11 मिनट स्पीच एंड दिस इज द फर्स्ट टाइम आई एम सेइंग इट आई डिड इट इन वन टेक एंड द फर्स्ट टेक एंड ऑल द होल 11 मिनट वाज डन इन वन टेक एंड मिस्टर बाल्की द मैन हु नेवर गेट्स हैप्पी अबाउट टेक्स ही सेड डन. And we actually thought we started morning shooting at around 9 o'clock. We thought this scene will carry on till about 5:30, 6 o'clock in the evening. But we packed up at 11 o'clock. We just finished the scene in one shot. And because I'll tell you honestly, when I was doing the scene, that scene particularly, when I was giving a speech in UN, and that scene actually came from my heart. And what I said in that scene is actually what I meant, every word, each and every word. And so that's all I can.
Marvelous. Thank you so much. As you said, what is a man if he can't stand up for women? Thank you very much. And we hope that you'll continue to do so.
Yes, ma'am.
Smriti ji, you're going to be heading from here straight to Parliament. We would like to hear from you what you're going to say to all the men who are the leaders of this country about this.
Now, I think that one of the most challenging conversations Twinkle and I and Tina and I have had is when I differed with her on one issue. Men or male political leaders cannot be made the villain of the piece. I feel that when Akshay's dialogue, can imagine a man bleeding for half an hour, what catastrophe would strike. I think if we want a change, you would like to ensure that men and women both are a part of the conversation, and that's why I'm happy to see so many men today watching this movie. I also feel that if you want to peg how a male political leader wants to bring about change and does so, well, in 2015, under a male Prime Minister, Narendra Modi, the first ever national guideline for menstrual hygiene management was dedicated to the entire country. So if there is one takeaway I, as a member of Parliament, would like from today's screening is, please read those guidelines. Many who are associated with UN in India work with schools, work with organizations that can have a far-reaching impact. If the movie has inspired you even a little bit, go read those guidelines and ensure that those guidelines help us empower teachers to have these conversations in schools. Those guidelines help us to have those conversations in Anganwadis with health workers. Those guidelines help us to engage with school management committees. Seriously, if you want to take this forward, please read those guidelines and see how you can apply it at your place of work or with people that your work influences. And I think that will be the best tribute to Arunachalam today. If you take those guidelines, which for the first time came in the history of this country, in 70 years, imagine, for the first time, it was a male politician who ensured those guidelines come through. So let's read them up and let's take them forward. And I think that should become the focus, the way forward. There is no doubt that this movie will be celebrated, given the kind of star cast and given the kind of director that they have. But the fact is, if we have to take the message forward beyond the box office success of the film, then please read the guidelines.